my fingers into my eyes. It's the only...
I miss him, you know, I miss the life that he had, you know. He was one of my best friends.
You know, my heart went away with him when it happened, you know, and I lived in a bottle of vodka for 8 months, you know, I mean, just miserable.
Slipknot og Pantera er to av mange rockeband som opp gjennom årene har mistet bandmedlemmer. Og artister reagerer forskjellig når suksess blir overskygget av tragiske dødsfall. Metallica brukte over 25 år på å takle sorgen etter bassist Cliff Burton døde i en bussulykke i Sverige. Mange trodde AC/DC var ferdig da Bon Scott ble funnet død i en bil i London. Men med ny vokalist Brian Johnson laget de det som skulle bli tidenes mestsellende rockalbum. Led Zeppelin brukte derimot 27 år på å stå sammen på en scene igjen etter trommeslager John Bonham drakk seg i hel i 1980. I flere tiår var Vinnie Paul og Dimebag Darrell sammen hver dag. De to brødrene som startet Pantera begynte med å sminke seg som Kiss i kjelleren hjemme i Texas, før de nådde førsteplass på Billboard-listo og reiste verden rundt.
Hey, this is me in London.
This is me in Barcelona.
This is me in Atlanta.
Moscow.
This is beyond the dream. This is called domination.
De to metalbrødrene holdt sammen i tykt og tynt. Da Pantera ble oppløst i 2003, gikk de rett tilbake i øvingslokalet, startet bandet Damageplan og dro ut på turné. Men planen om å erobre verden på nytt fikk en brå slutt.
Anxious fans packed the concert hall to hear the group and one of the country's most known guitarists, Dimebag Darrell Abbott, play.
Etter bare noen minutter av konserten løper en ukjent mann opp på scenen, retter en pistol mot Dimebag Darrell og løsner to skudd.
911 emergency.
I'm at the Oasis. They're off! And there's a shooting. Someone is shooting the band on the stage.
Someone's shooting the band on the stage.
Dimebag Darrell har gått fra å være feire rockestjerner til å bli internasjonale nyheter.
A camera belonging to Dimebag Darrell's band captured the scene as it played out that December night.
In total, the gunman killed four people and injured three others.
Bak trommesettet satt Vinnie Paul, som uten å vite om det, nettopp hadde utvekslet sine siste ord med broren.
I mean, the last words that we said to each other, we knuckle-chucked each other and said Van Halen. That was our code word for just let it all hang out, man. Every time we ever saw Van Halen, it was like, they don't give a fuck if they make mistakes or whatever. They're just fucking jamming and going for it, you know? And that was kind of our code. There's no explanation, you know? It's something that has never happened. You know, it has never happened. There's nobody been killed on stage, you know. It's also eerily similar to what happened to John Lennon. Same exact day, December 8th, almost the same time, you know. You just can't explain those kind of things, you know. It's something that, I would hope never happens ever again to anybody.
Mens Pantera gikk inn i historiebøkene, ble Slipknot et av de største metalbandene på 2000-tallet. I likhet med Pantera topper de albumlisto i USA, men så traff tragedien deg også. Og brått fant bandet seg i medias søkelys av helt feil grunner.
911.
Vi har en gentleman vi tror er passet ut. Vi tror det er en drug-overdose. There's a hypodermic needle next to the bed here, so...
Okay, so he's not awake.
Oh, God, no.
Tonight, fans and friends are shocked and saddened over the death of Paul Gray. The co-founder and bass player for the Grammy Award-winning band was found dead in an Urbandale hotel room.
Trying to explain it to someone is very hard. I mean, it's almost like the only way I've ever really been able to sum it up is, like, cut off both your arms and legs. And then live your life. I mean, it's such a tragedy, you know? I mean, it really is. But the thing that I've had to do, that I've had to learn to do, is focus on him and how he lived, you know? And how much I miss him, you know? I miss the life that he had. I mean, there's still days that it's really hard for me, but I continue in the spirit of him, you know? I mean, you know, there are moments, the really good moments on stage, I know he's there, you know, and I know he's sharing it with me.
Vokalisten bestemte seg for at den beste terapien var å fortsette livet på scenen.
I don't want to get too into it.
Bare en veke etter Paul Gray døde, spilte Corey Taylor konsert med sideprosjektet Stone Sour.
It was heavy duty, you know. I mean, it was still very fresh, but it, for some reason, it all culminated in that night.
This is for my friend. Wish I was too dead to cry. My
self-affliction. Mens Corey Taylor brukte konserter for å komme seg videre etter tapet, var veien tilbake til scenen lengre for Vinnie Paul.
I didn't know if I'd ever do it again or not, man.
Gjennombruddet kom da Chad Gray fra bandet Mudvayne ringte Vinnie Paul for å invitere til å starte nytt band.
These dudes started calling me and saying, hey man, what do you think about playing in a band? And I was like, man, it sounds cool, but I don't know if I'm ready to do this yet or not, you know? And they kept calling me and caught me one night when I'd been drinking some red wine and listening to some Kiss, and I went, you know what? I think it's time, man. Let's give it a shot. Let's see what happens. We drank a lot. The next day, we went down to the studio, which was another big step, my brother's studio, where we recorded the last couple of Pantera records. Trust me, it was pretty heavy, man. It was heavy. It was very nerve-wracking and just so many thoughts, you know? His pictures are on the wall, platinum records on the wall. After we got through that first song, I could just feel it was the right thing to do, you know? I could feel his energy. It was like, come on, you gotta do this, keep going, you know?
Vinnie Paul put it best. He was like, you're living for two now, you know? I mean, that's a spirit that big doesn't go away.
After you grieve and you come to grips with what's happened, you gotta live twice as hard, man. You know, that's what they expect from us, and we're not going to let them down.